In this video, I want to talk a little bit about foundations of the new Microsoft Stream on SharePoint. And what I mean specifically is, what is the organizational structure of Stream on SharePoint? How does that, mesh with what we had in Stream Classic? So a question that keeps coming up is, what about my stream channels? I have stream channels, and all I've thought about is creating a channel in Microsoft Stream. And I think the best way to address this concern or this question is to start with the foundation in Microsoft 365. So the secret sauce of why Microsoft 365 is a top-tier collaboration platform, it has to do with a construct called Microsoft 365 Groups. The reason why you take all of these applications in Microsoft 365 and you can't really just swap one out with a non-Microsoft version, it's not an equal one-to-one split, is because there's this underlying foundation called a Microsoft 365 group. And that's what enables all of these applications in the platform to work so well together. So I think it's good for us to start with the foundation of what is a Microsoft 365 group and how does that apply to Microsoft Stream. A Microsoft 365 group is just a collection of people that have permission to access a collaborative space. They have some collaborative tools given to them, like SharePoint, Stream, OneNote, Forms, things like that. The group construct is not an app in and of itself. It's just a way to group people together and start collaborating together. So whenever you create a group, you get a complete tool set of a complete toolbox of tools that you can use to collaborate. You get a mailbox, you get some storage backed by SharePoint, you get a calendar provided, in Outlook. You get a OneNote notebook by default. You can group your forms together and share your forms in Microsoft Forms with your group. You can have Teams channels if you choose the Microsoft Teams route. There's all of these tools available to you in a Microsoft 365 group. And there's three types of main groups. So the three major types of groups are Microsoft Teams, which is a chat-based experience. Yammer communities, which is social media, is kind of the whole point of that. And then everything else is really at the very basic level considered an Outlook group. And that means that, like, if you create a group in Outlook or in one of these other apps other than like Teams and Yammer, you're going to get the same thing of an Outlook group, a stream channel, a planner plan, and a SharePoint site along with some other things. So this graphic, I've lifted this from my good friend Matt Wade at Jump to 365. If you want more information about this construct, he has a fantastic page that covers end to end what a Microsoft 365 group is. I'm just kind of paraphrasing and using his graphic. So credit where credit is due. Go check out jumptothe365.com. But he's got the best way I've seen it visualized is this infographic. And this infographic is fantastic because it says, if I create a community in Yammer, then I become the owner of a group that has everything in green. So if you go to Yammer, you create a group, then you get a Yammer feed, you have access to Microsoft Forms where you can store forms, you get a notebook, you can have planner plans and planner boards. You can use Power BI in the group construct. You get a SharePoint site for your file storage. For the Yammer example, this is where the attachments for Yammer, they go to the SharePoint site. And then you also get access to a stream group where you can create channels inside that group and group your videos together. You can kind of organize your videos. If I go in Teams and I create a team, I get everything in purple. Forms, OneNote, Planner, Power BI, a SharePoint site, that's the Files tab inside of Microsoft Teams, and again, a stream video portal where you can create channels for your Microsoft team and organize your videos. You also get Teams chat and Teams wiki if you go through Teams. So let's like simplify this a little bit. Let's take everything out except for Microsoft Stream. If I create a group in Stream, I get a stream video portal and I can make channels. That's where a lot of people's like knowledge is kind of siloed right there. But this entire time you've been using Microsoft Stream, you've had access to all of these other tools in your Microsoft 365 group. So if you create a Stream group and make some channels, you get a Stream portal, but you also get a SharePoint site. You can also create a Power BI workspace. You can add forms and you can assign them to that Stream group that you've created. You get all of the goodies of a Microsoft 365 group. You just may not have understood that if you've only worked inside of Stream. So Stream Classic, the migration to Stream on SharePoint is really just, we're taking the videos from Stream Classic, we're putting them into the SharePoint that already exists. So in the migration tool that the administrators are going to run to migrate videos over to SharePoint, a SharePoint site already is mapped to your group inside of Microsoft Stream. So there's actually a default location and there's a good folder for your stuff to go into. So I hope that kind of simplifies the fact that, like, you've got this group construct that might be a little bit hard to digest, but at the Stream level, suffice it to say, when you created a Stream group back in 2020, you got a video portal. You also had a SharePoint you may not have even known about. That's where we're going to put our Stream on SharePoint stuff. So moving on to specifically Microsoft Stream Classic and the organizational structure, I want to map that type of structure to what do we have over in Stream on SharePoint. How is it different? How is it similar? So in Stream Classic, you had two main constructs. You have a group, which we just went over as an M365 group. And then you had your regular user account, right? Inside of your Stream account, you just upload a video to your own account. So inside of the groups, you may have created one or more channels, and then you organize your videos into those channels. Inside of your user account, you simply just upload the videos to your account, you share them, and you're done, right? So the constructs within Stream Classic are, you've got groups. They are the parent of channels. So a channel is inside of a group in this M365 group world. And then channels are just a way to organize your videos. They're loosely associated with one or more channels. You're associating a video with a channel. It's organizing, it's putting it in, just like, surprise, surprise, a folder. On the user side, anybody can upload videos to their own account and they can just ad hoc share, right? You can upload it, share it, you're done. When we move to SharePoint, you'll notice that the structure is very similar, right? Instead of a Stream group, we have a SharePoint site, right? We have an M365 group. Instead of your user account in Stream Classic, that's your OneDrive, that's your personal space, right? And then the easiest way, the most like equal way to describe this is that my recommendation would be, in your SharePoint site that already exists, you can create folders and then you can organize your videos in those folders. They're just files when it comes to SharePoint. But new Stream on SharePoint optimizes the playback and it's video centric. It's more of a first class citizen when it comes to files in SharePoint. So you got your SharePoint site. In that document library, just create folders. Those are the equivalent of channels. Put your videos in those folders, and now you've got quote unquote channels. Inside of OneDrive, upload them anywhere you want in your OneDrive. You might create a video folder, or you just put it in the root. It doesn't matter. And then you can share it on an ad hoc basis. So to recap that, we've got SharePoint sites. They provide the storage, right? And they provide that structure, that organization, and they also provide permissions to the videos themselves. So you can share a video individually, you can give people access to the whole folder, or you can give people access to the whole site. It's kind of like you could make your Stream group public to everybody in the company. Folders, again, just like channels, they're a great way to organize your videos. A bonus is that whenever you get into using web parts for SharePoint, this is a way that you can filter your videos, you can filter your web parts by that folder. So I recommend organizing, you know, so you don't just have 800 videos in one folder. Try to have a little bit of structure to it. And then again, with OneDrive, just like Stream Classic user account, you can upload to your OneDrive. You can share them on an ad hoc basis. That's totally fine, up to you. And then OneDrive is the default. If you use the upload button on stream.office.com, then OneDrive will be the default location. Also, if you use the new web recorder on stream.office.com, it's also going to save by default to your OneDrive. That's totally fine because you have the option to move that file wherever you want. So if you go through the happy path of just, you know, creating a video using the upload button, it's going to put it on OneDrive. You can move it anywhere within OneDrive, or you can jump from OneDrive, move it into any SharePoint site that you own. You put it in any folder that you want. You have full flexibility. So getting down to like, where should I put my videos? What's the philosophy around, do I use OneDrive or do I use SharePoint for my needs, for my video consumption? It's time, I think, to bring back my graphic of like what to use when. I created this about 4 years ago to explain the difference between like, when do I use Teams? When do I use Yammer? When do I use OneDrive? And it applies here to video creation as well. So it's best to think of this as like a cross section of the earth, right? You've got the core, the mantle, the crust, and at the core level, your very personal files, that's your OneDrive. That's the most private place within 365. If you put videos here, they are private unless you choose to share them. So sharing is a manual effort where you're going to share these files with people. This is where I put my individual work-related files. I put them in my OneDrive, right? Microsoft Teams, this is where I work with people regularly. I know these people. We're working on a project together. Organizationally, we're together. I'm closer to these people. That's one level out. We're now collaborating by default. One level out from there, kind of getting to the outer loop communications, is Yammer. This is the people that I work around or I share a common interest with, right? Again, we're collaborating by default. We're in a shared space called a Microsoft 365 group, but I don't necessarily know these people. We all like dogs, so we're in a dog group together, right? And then SharePoint at that outer crust, when we're talking about SharePoint sites by themselves, like communication sites, that's when I need to share information with a large group of people, right? It's more of a broadcast. We're not quite having like a two-way conversation. I'm more publishing stuff out to SharePoint by itself. Now, behind the scenes, if you remember that graphic of the M365 groups, behind Teams and behind Yammer is also SharePoint. That provides the storage capabilities for Yammer and for Teams and for SharePoint by itself. So all of these three down here, these are SharePoint. And then you have OneDrive. Again, we have those two levels of where we can put our videos. So my personal recommendation is, if you're going to do a one-off video ad hoc and you have like a limited scope of where you're going to share it, it's not going to be shared forever with 800,000 people. If it's just, I created a video, I want to share it with my friend Lee, and I want to get his input on it, or I want to share it with five people. Or another example is I just did a metaverse project at work where I created a video about how to put on a VR headset, right? And that was shared with a pretty large group of people, but it was for an event we call Milestones, where at the end of that event, that video doesn't matter anymore. You know, the event is over. So I had a limited period of time I was going to share that video. What I did personally, I put it on my OneDrive and then I shared it with the people I needed to share it with. Now that the event is over, I don't care about sharing the video anymore. That is OneDrive. So if you got limited scope, limited timeline, go ahead and put it in OneDrive. That's great. If you're going to be more open-ended and you're going to have long-term storage, or you're going to share it with a large group of people for a long period of time, and you want that video to stay past your time at the organization, right? You leave, the video remains. That's SharePoint for you. So think of this as, if I'm going to ad hoc share OneDrive, if I need a place to host my video, get in the mindset of hosting your video. If you're hosting your video, that's SharePoint. You should have a SharePoint site. That could be a team, it could be a Yammer community, or it could be a standalone SharePoint site if you want to. But the main point is, it's SharePoint if it's open-ended sharing. So I hope that kind of explains and demystifies a little bit of this, like, what's the difference between SharePoint and OneDrive? I used to have channels. What do I do about my channels? Those are folders in SharePoint. I think there's a little bit of a fear that I have that like we're overthinking this a little bit and overcomplicating it. At the end of the day, if I go back to these two structures, you'll note that like if you just take this path, this guidance, your structure you had in Classic is identical to what you have in SharePoint. Just think of it that way. Think of SharePoint in folders where you had groups and channels in the old world. So, I hope that makes sense. Feel free to leave a comment, ask questions. I'm here and available to answer those for you, and we'll get into the new SharePoint stream together. Thanks for watching. Bye.